Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. In this session, we will see a very simple IC. It is a four terminal device. It is KA5L0380 series IC. It have many numbers: KA5H0365, KA5M0365, KA5L0365, HML. Then we have other number KA5M0365RN, 365L365RN, H0380R, M0380R, L0380R. It is a family. It is in DIP package and it is in TO224L, this package. And we are discussing 5L0380. So we will discuss just only one IC, L0380R. It is 167 and 50 kilohertz. H, that is 100, M 67, and L 50 kilohertz. Either it is in DIP package, 8 pin, or 4 pin package. So it have 4 terminal. Pin number 1, if we see here, in 4 terminal device, pin number 1, that is ground. Pin 2 is drain. So it have built in MOSFET inside, and the MOSFET control circuit. Pin number 4, feedback. Pin number 3, VCC. It have overvoltage protection circuit. Then different circuits are inside: thermal protection and internal oscillator. If you see its switching frequency, if it is KA5H0365 or H0380, it is 100 kHz. H, high frequency. M, medium frequency, that is 67 kHz. And L, either it is L0365 5R, 365RN, or 380RN, or 380R, 50 kHz. Duty cycle for H series, maximum 67%. M and L, both versions will 77% maximum. Working voltage, start threshold voltage, V startup, 15 volt. And V stop 9 volt, 8.4 volt. This is the lower level. Upper level 15 to 16 volt maximum. Here is its sample circuit. We have DC rail voltage here. Then there is a startup resistor. Normally in this IC, 500 to 600 kilo ohm resistor. This resistor is used at pin number 3 to provide VCC voltage and provide soft start. When this IC will start switching, at that time auxiliary winding voltage will start to replenish this capacitor. Pin number 1, that is the chip ground and MOSFET ground, and it will switch from ground to drain. Drain is connected with the transformer winding. Other end of the transformer winding is connected to positive DC rail. It will switch when the voltage will maintained in the output side. Most of the time it is used in multi-section power supplies, set-top boxes, computer power supplies, printers. When the voltage will maintained at output side, only one power supply will be regulated, other power supplies are unregulated. But these will follow this 5 voltage, which is the main required power supply. At that time, when the supply will maintained, it will switch this ground level to 4 number pin, that is feedback pin. To test this circuit, I will place on the project board this IC in this way, that pin number 1, that is at left side, as pin number 1, that is ground pin. I will use boost converter to apply voltage. It have 5 volt input, and we can adjust voltage up to our required voltage. The upper rail, that is positive voltage. So we will use the positive voltage to apply to VCC pin, that is pin number 3. we will apply this adjustable power supply to pin number 3. Pin number 1 we will connect to ground. So pin number 1 is connected to ground, and we will use 10 kilo ohm potentiometer, and I will place it here to adjust the feedback. We are just going to verify the function of this IC. One end of the potentiometer I will connect to ground, and the center slider, that is wiper of the potentiometer, I will take output and I will connect to pin number 4. And I will use 1 kilo ohm resistor. One end will be connected to pin number 2, and second end I will connect it here. Resistor one end to pin number 2, second end is open. This end grounded. This end we will connect one resistor, we will apply 12 volt. At this point we will apply variable voltage from 6 volt to 16 volt positive. This end, pin number 4, we will connect here 10 kilo ohm resistor, 1 kilo ohm load resistor. So this is the pin number 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is the connection. I am connecting 5 volt here, and this is the ground side. I will turn on the oscilloscope. At this end I connected 12 volt positive. I will monitor the DC voltage. This is the positive terminal. These are positive voltage. We will monitor the VCC voltage, that at which voltage this IC will start functioning. This end is ground. So we have 9.4 volt, and I will drop this voltage up to 5 volt. Okay, that's good. And I will connect this ground, and I will connect oscilloscope probe to the resistor. This time 5.7 volt, and we don't have any output on the screen. Now I will increase the voltage at DC rail at pin number 3. Now I am increasing voltage 8.9 volt. volt. I will adjust the feedback as well. 15. Yes, this is the startup voltage. As we discussed, this IC have startup threshold minimum 14 to 16 volts. Now it is working. And when the output voltage are maintained, this feedback signal will cause to adjust the duty cycle from minimum to maximum. we can see minimum duty cycle to maximum duty cycle. From minimum to maximum, this IC will adjust its duty cycle. If we have some power supply that we cannot detect the fault, we can remove that IC from the board and we can test it very simply, and it is giving exact 50 kilohertz. If I will check frequency using this multimeter between ground and the pin number 2, we can see 49.4 kilohertz. Excellent. And if I will check the duty cycle, it is showing 21%. We have 15 volt and this IC is working. Now I will decrease the voltage. Now the voltage are being decreased. This IC is still working. This is its regulation window. It will sense the load and it will check the load size, how much wattage are there. Still it is working. When there is no load in the output side, this IC will receive approximately 9 to 10 volt. So that it will understand that there is no load. When the load will increase, the output voltage will decrease, but the auxiliary winding voltage will start increasing, and it will, and this IC will become to know that there is load being added on the output side. We can see 8.8 volt, this IC stopped working. Now this is its reboot mode. Now it will wait until the voltage at VCC pin are being maintained again by the startup resistor, and the start VCC capacitor will charge again, that is connected at pin number 3. Still this IC is off until it will reach its upper threshold for startup. Yes, this IC started working now. This is its regulation, from minimum duty cycle to maximum duty cycle. And now this IC will keep working until the voltage are dropped less than 8.8 volt, 8.9 volt, 8.5 volt, yes 8.8 volt, this IC stopped working. Why? Because it's under voltage lockout. If you have IC H, that will work at 100 kilohertz, M 67, L 50 kilohertz. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.